Thought I did that chopper, and I see your point.
Tutty. With the tut.
Yo! School Samantha Lambs, Paul and San Django Joe, come back one time for everybody on this MLK Day. This is when it's being recorded, when it's being put out. Probably later. Yo, man, welcome to the channel. This is an Abundant Speaker channel where we speak it out, we feel it, we keep it real. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Know what I'm saying? If you are a veteran, you're a trauma victim, if you've been through some things, if you're having a tough time dealing with life, if you're looking for some answers to questions you never knew you needed to ask, welcome to the Django Joe Show. You're looking for the merchandise? You're looking for the merchandise? Ain't just hoodies, baby. We got it coming. Know what I'm saying? This fall is going to be popping. And just to let you know, 4HFVibes.org. Get everything. You know what I mean? Including the books. All right? So with that being said, look, if you're looking for, I guess, a place to understand that you're understood and you can just relax, chill for 30 minutes to an hour, and just take all the stress away while you have somebody tell you some stuff that's good for your soul. You know what I mean? Welcome to the Django Joe Show. With that being said, again, if you're looking for the merchandise, I'm going to repeat it until you do it. Know what I'm saying? I'm going to repeat it until you do it because it's bigger than me. 4HFVibes.org. You feel me? And with that being said, know what I'm saying? We're going to kick it real special today for MLK Day. I'm going to promise you that. Me and my little Walmart watch, we're going to tell you how it is. You feel me? So with no further ado, look at me, I'm going to look at you. Let's make it happen. Yo, School's Man and Lambs, Paul and San Django Joe, come back one time for your mind. If you're looking for the merchandise looking oh so nice, make sure you go to 4HFVibes.org. You heard me? That way when you get a book, and I'm telling you now, I'm not making like all these other dudes make 100 of these things. I'm only making like 10. Matter of fact, I'm only making four. I want these to be exclusive. So when you rock these, and you know they raw, you ain't gonna see nobody else with them on. None of that. And all you gotta do is buy a book. Matter of fact, speaking of books, Super Sane 1, The Art of Going Super Sane, is coming to a Amazon virtual reality bookstore near you so you can purchase it and make sure that you're going super sane, just, you know what I'm saying, just like I am, all the way. Yeah, look at me. All right, now, one time for your mind, man. Welcome to the Django Joe Show, where we speak it how we feel and we keep it real in this Ebonic Speaking Channel. Like I said before, I'm trying to do this thing without cursing. Because apparently, you know what I'm saying, once you get monetized, y'all look at my views and stuff like that, they done took away some of my views, they done took away a whole bunch of stuff, you know what I'm saying? Some of my videos is, I'll put it like this, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm not a big channel yet, but I'm on my way to being a big channel. The views I get don't coexist with YouTube's algorithm for that. They're like, yo, you're here, how are you making stuff up here? And it's just like, look, when you got a message, you got a message. And when people hear it, they feel it. So they'll regulate to what you feel you should have as opposed to what you actually got. And that's okay because it goes up and down. Like once you research YouTube and you know what's going on. You know what I'm saying? If you don't, you'll be like, oh, that man. You know what I'm saying? But we ain't got time for all that. But look up. Today is MLK Day. All right? Today is MLK Day. If you know about MLK, every black person does. And for those that don't, MLK was an African-American male born in, I believe, Atlanta, Georgia, around that area. You know what I mean? And that man had a dream. How he went about his dream, there's a lot of perspectives saying a lot of different things, but at the end of the day, the end result was that man made a positive change for the lives of other people, and it cost him his life. Was he the best father in the world? After researching, no. Was he the best pastor in the world? No. Was he the best person in the world? No, he was human. He made human mistakes. Martin Luther King cheated on his wife more times than I care to go into, as not to besmirch the legacy of the greatness that is Martin Luther King. Know what I'm saying? Junior. You heard me? But it's just like when you look at what he did, you know, you have to sit there and say, and this is why I said this is going to be a special Django Joe Show episode, was the untimely alleged passing of Martin Luther King worth it? Know what I'm saying? Think about that now. If you would look at today's times and look at the times way back in the 1950s, the 1960s, the 1970s, the 1980s, know what I'm saying? Like, let's just go back to that time. Know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, just the 1950s and 1960s. Let's go back to that time and look at it. Now, if you're educated on black history, and I'm like a historian, that was my thing. For all you young, smart people that are watching this show that know gosh darn well, you're not supposed to be on up. But teach you something. So back then, you know, you weren't the same, you know, Caucasian people that you look at, like I said, I'm trying not to curse, and people are so sensitive nowadays, I need this paycheck. So you're going to see me use a lot of big words that are going to be unknown to some people's vocabularies, but we're here to learn. So back in the days, man, a lot of these Caucasian people that you see now, they grew up in the segregation area. My teachers were the children of the racist people who said, you can't be on this side of the road if you're this color. You know what I'm saying? Those were my teachers. So can you imagine, and that's like high level narcissism. Can you imagine what it's like growing up and seeing, you know, whites only, coloreds only, you know what I mean? Like that would make you feel some kind of way mentally growing up. Like I said, we're here for the full circle. I'm finna take it up. We finna go deep, you feel me? Now understand, just because a group of people with high authority said, you know what, we're not gonna make things seem like they are. These African Americans are doing a lot for the community, and even though, you know, I may not like them, I understand that, you know, they have a right to live like everybody else. That's fine. If the higher ups say so and it rains down, guess what? It's open rain now. Black people can do what y'all want to do to an extent. You know what I'm saying? Now with that, you have to look at, there have been decades, like centuries, like y'all want to talk about desegregation. It literally was less than 100 years ago since we were desegregated. It's literally like less than what it was in the 50s. I think desegregation in 1958, I believe that happened. So if you look at, and I may be wrong, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it was 1958 or 1959, or it was in the early 1960s. But believe and look at that, bro. Your mom and dad were probably born, if you're around my age, I'm 30-something. My mom and dad were born in the 1960s. That's like barely scraping past segregation, which means their parents, my grandparents, were the children who grew up in, like, you can't go on that side of the road. You can't go on that side of town. Like, imagine that. Now, fast forward 50 years later, you know what I mean? And you're looking at things. We done had, you know, the first alleged black president, Barack Obama, and then you have people out here that are whistleblowing, and you're doing research, and you come to find out that, you know what I'm saying, some people are saying Abraham Lincoln was black. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just like you look at history, and you just understand that it's all a lie. The more you look deeper into history, the more you understand, like, it's just all, it's all about the person that was alive last. That's what the historians use, the survivor. You know what I'm saying? Whether you're a real survivor like me, or whether you're one of those guys that played, you know, played the shadows and just sat there and acted like you were cool with everybody and just low-key were caking notes, you know what I'm saying? Yo, you got to look at it for what it is. So with that being said, look at life, bro. Like, it's the 1950s, and you're finally able to walk on the side of town because the government says so. Do you believe the people in that area are going to be welcoming? No. Do you believe the people in that area are going to be teaching their children to be tolerant in the 1950s? No. You think that happened in the 1960s? No. You think that happened after Martin Luther King died? And we're in the 1970s now, I believe? No. You think that happened in the 1980s? No. You know what I'm saying? So what was the point? That's what I'm trying to get to. Like, what was the point? Because you had a whole movement, a whole group of black people were sitting there correlating and coexisting together, cohabitating, talking about we're finna overcome and we can do this, and we done got the rights to sit on the bus in the front and all this good jazz. And it's just like, when you sit back and think about all that, and then as soon as he passed, everybody forgot about it. Now you just got people out here getting high and doing drugs. Wow, sounds like it's 2021, you feel me? Now you got people out here, you know, and I'm gonna say this part, you got people out here that are like, you know, they act like they ain't racist because it's the unpopular opinion to be openly racist, but they're still doing things behind closed doors that inhibit the, I guess, that inhibit people of color being able to accelerate and climb up ladders. You know what I'm saying? Is it right? No. But does it happen? Yeah. You know what I mean? Everybody wants equality, but nobody looks at equity. You know what I'm saying? If I'm 4 foot tall and I'm at a 6 foot fence and you're 6 foot one and another guy is 7 foot three, but they give us all 1 1-foot box to stand on to look over that wall, that's equal. You get what I'm saying? But if it were to be honest, if you already know you can see over the wall, the other guy can see over the wall, y'all don't need the box. Give the box to the short guy who needs to stand up. You know what I'm saying? That's just being equitable, but people don't look at it like that. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not here trying to start a movement or nothing like that, because at the end of the day, what do movements solve? Show me one movement that was ran and started by a black person that ended well. Do that for me. You know what I'm saying? Think about that real quick. The Black Panther Party movement, started by a black person, did not end well. Know what I'm saying? If you can guess where I'm going with this, then know what I'm saying? You can look at the civil rights movement started by multiple black people. It didn't end well. You know what I'm saying? I mean, the result, yeah, black people got more freedom, but it's just like when you look at how powerful some of those people were, and then you look at how they met an untimely demise in such a way that was like, man, you would think that the people that they were helping would actually protect them instead of gaining everything that they could from their loss of life. You get what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't make sense. That's why I'm like, I personally don't believe in movements. Don't follow me. Don't try to be like me. Be like yourself. You feel me? Because at the end of the day, I'm not finna sit here and have a bunch of people trying to practice what I preach, when in reality, the only thing is I'm doing is being better than I was yesterday. If you can't do that, don't try to copy me and do it how I do it, because it ain't gonna work. You feel me? Like, it's just, when you look at Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, they received so much hate from their own people that it made no sense for people to sit there and be, as soon as this man passed away, oh, it's kumbaya time, we can all lock arms and, you know, keep it rocking like that. Like, how do you sit there and look at somebody's face after you did everything you could to drag that man through the dirt for him just trying to help you out in a way that you haven't thought about or you just couldn't do, so you didn't want to be involved and you wanted everybody around your circle to not be involved? That sounds like a narcissistic smear campaign, don't it? When the narcissistic individual talks about you like you're garbage to everybody else, and you just keep on going, you keep on fighting to get to that mountaintop, and they just keep on putting in more and more obstacles in your way so you can't do it. Man, a narcissistic campaign. And we didn't know about narcissism back then. These are new words to my vocabulary, so I know to a lot of other people they're new also. So imagine that. Look at Martin Luther King like he was just an empath. You know what I mean? They say he had an INFJ personality type. He was a sigma male, you know what I'm saying? Or he was a, which is like, you know, you got the hierarchy, beta male, alpha male, sigma male, I do my own thing. You know what I mean? He was a sigma male. He did his own thing. He had a voice. He had a powerful way of speaking that got people's attention because of his mind state. He saw things at different angles. Like I said, was he a perfect man? No. But what he did do that people need to understand and appreciate was this man took his time to make sure that other people would have a chance. Now, he, in my opinion, he put a curse on himself when he said, you know, I may not see it with you. Like, oh, I mean, be careful what you say. You know what I mean? Because obviously you didn't make it. And if you did make it, if Martin Luther King would be here today, you know what I'm saying? Like that one Boondocks episode where he came back and he was looking at it like, bro, I died for this. You know what I mean? And I say this part right here after we pause for the calls real quick. I'll say this right up. If you're a black person and you're out here screaming Black Lives Matter, but you have a problem with another black person, do not celebrate Martin Luther King Day. Do not scream Black Lives Matter. Sit your hypocritical self down somewhere and reevaluate your life. If you're a black woman and you got a black dude on child support and you're not allowing him to see his kids, sit your hypocritical self down. Don't celebrate Black Lives Matter and what they're doing. Don't celebrate Martin Luther King Day or Black History Month. Know what I'm saying? Go somewhere. Sit your hip. Know what I'm saying? Go somewhere. If you're a black man and you're downing black women, even if they may not be your preference, but you specifically down black women every chance you get, don't celebrate MLK Day. Sit your hypocritical self down. Don't celebrate Black History Month. Don't celebrate Black Lives Matter. Know what I'm saying? Because, and I keep saying don't, because obviously if you were really doing what the intentions of these groups were, you know what I'm saying, to help people, you would understand that it's not people that you don't know, it's people that you do know. You get what I'm saying? If you're a black dude and you're doing everything you can to hold back another brother from trying to do things that you can't, instead of trying to uplift him like how Martin Luther King would have wanted, since you love him so much, like the Black Lives Matter movement would have wanted, since you love that so much, like Black History Month stands for, since you love that so much, stop celebrating. You get me? Because you're not standing by the standards of what that group was meant for, or what those groups were meant for, or what, you know, upliftment of black people were meant for. You know what I'm saying? You ain't doing all that. You're just sitting there in the way. You know what I mean? Sitting there, and I swear, this is why I keep it by myself around. This is why I kick it by myself now, because it's just like, when you sit there and you look at it, I can't chill around no black guy that's sitting there helping a black woman cheat on her black husband, her black boyfriend, the black stepdaddy that's taking care of those black kids and showing them what it's like to be in a strong male presence. I can't kick it around a type of person that can do that to another black person and then scream that they're pro-black. Where are you pro-black at? Because if you can help somebody cheat, you're destroying the family. You're destroying the foundation. You're teaching future generations things that they don't need to learn. And you're sitting here talking about, you know, I'm pro this, I'm pro that. You're pro nah. Straight up, you're pro nah, bro. And if you can start saying that just like that, like, I'm pro nah. No, what's that mean? That means I'm a hypocrite, bro. That's what you are. You're a hypocrite. If you're a black woman and you understood for the past few decades the string of single parentism, the string of, you know, miseducated masculine women being taught that this is how true masculinity is, when in reality, masculinity is just being an adult about a situation, putting your pride to the side and making sure that you can take care of your responsibilities. You're out here making sure that you're dragging the name of the black man through the dirt. You're dragging the name of the black woman through the dirt by being a poor example for your kids on what it's like to be black. You're out here perpetuating every stereotype in existence, but at the same time screaming that you want respect. Hey, trust me. Stop saying that you're pro-black. You're not. Nothing about you is. I don't care if you're wearing weave, if you're wearing dreads, if you're wearing a fro. If you're out here making it hard for other black people of other skin tones, you know what I'm saying? Whether you're light or dark, I don't care. If you're making it hard for other black people and you black, stop saying or that you celebrate or you down with Martin Luther King Day or you're down with the Black Lives Matter movement or you're down with being, you know what I'm saying, a part of black history. You're not. You're the hindrance. You get what I'm saying? And I don't care if it's on a small level. If you stole a lighter out your homeboy house and you don't know the significance of that lighter, but you stole from another black man, hey, bro, look up. I'm not gonna hang around you because you're a hypocrite. You get what I'm saying? Like, this is how deep it gets. If you sat there and you saw somebody that's on the road of, I guess, going down a direction that you know is gonna be damaging for their life, as in if you talking about you an OG in these streets and you ain't out there trying to take care of these kids for real, bro, and, you know, like I said, I don't talk politics. I ain't talking all that. I'm talking about for these, you know what I'm saying? If you in situations and organizations and doing things and how y'all do things how y'all do things. What I'm saying is for them people that sit there and fake the funk and make everybody look bad because they want to be attentionist and get, you know, a little bit of popularity. I'm talking about them folks. So if you run here talking about, you know what I'm saying, you're a gangster, but at the same time, you know, serving death to the community, I can't look at you and be like you're pro-black. I can't, know what I'm saying? Because that's paradoxical. That's hypocritical, know what I'm saying? If you're around here talking about you, you know, if pretty much if you're around here as an adult and you watching black kids go in a direction they ain't supposed to go, which has been the past few decades of us adults, you feel me? Stop saying you're pro-black, you're pro this and that. You can watch, and I'm talking about, yeah, like anybody that can sit there, even family. You know what I mean? If you got a son, a nephew, a daughter, a niece, a cousin, an aunt, an uncle that's trying to do something productive for the community, and you're sitting there dogging them to the bone behind their back but smiling in their face, stop saying that you're down for the black community, that you're pro this, you're pro that. You're hypocritical. And what the sad part is about it is that, again, as soon as Martin Luther King Jr. died, Malcolm X had already passed away, I believe. And I believe Malcolm passed away, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, memory, you know what I'm saying? I might be wrong, and I'm not afraid to say I'm wrong if I'm wrong. But here's the thing, though. Once those two people died, you ain't never going to get another Martin Luther King again, bro. Ever. You ain't never going to get another Malcolm X again. Ever. Because for those of people that aspire to want to be like that, bro, if you're looking at it from my angle, like, what did that solve? If we're still in the same place, there's memes online talking about the hood under Bush, the hood under Clinton, the hood under Bush again, the hood under Obama, and the hood under Trump. It's the same picture. You get what I'm saying? Like, if ain't nothing changing, then at some point, you know, you got to stop sitting there acting like it will, bro. And that's what I'm saying. Like, you have to understand that at some point, bro, like, there has to be legitimate change. It's only a matter of time. And what's crazy to me is these same racist people who grew up hating black people, these same racist black people who grew up hating other black people that look different than what they do, and they want to sit here and, you know, talk their jazz, but it's just a bunch of bull. Like, for real, bro. Like, look at it, dog. If you ain't got no low cut, you automatically a thug. I'm like, bro, I done broke every thug stereotype in the book at this point, bro. Like, know what I'm saying? Like, it's all perception. You feel me? And this is, again, why I don't talk religion or politics, because if you want me to go there, I'll go there, and I'll say some things that can shake some, make some things shake, but it's just like being real. The only way to make change is to be that change, and that's how I see it, bro. Like, the only honest way to make change is to be that change, bro. And if you're tired of seeing things in a certain light, do what you got to do to be it, you know what I'm saying? If you're tired of seeing kids walking around constantly, you know what I'm saying? Like, what? I saw a dude in the mall the other day with a purse. You heard me? And the old version of me would have been like, man, that's sad that this black kid is sitting there with a purse on. And, you know, but then the new version of me with my new train of thought, I'm sitting here like, if that's what that young man has to do to go outside based off the experiences in his life, probably the lack of, you know, masculinity and all these other things, probably the pro-sick of that. You could, and it's like, bro, like, no offense to any single mothers, no offense to any children of single mothers, but you could tell a child of a single mother, bro. You know what I'm saying? You could tell a child of a single mother, you could tell the child of a single mother from a single mother, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, you saw the lack of something in that boy. And to where, like I said, I would have judged him if I was in the old frame of mind, my younger frame of mind, I would have judged him. You know what I'm saying? But being older and looking at it, I'm like, you know what? The fact that he could come outside and feel comfortable by himself, even though he rocking the purse, hey, bro, do what you gotta do. You feel me? And I was, and I'm talking about, he had like the silly little skinny string thing. I'm like, damn, cuz, that's how he rock. But he would just, you know what I mean? Do what you gotta do to be happy. I'm pro happy. I'm pro, you know what I'm saying? I'm pro seeing people smile. I'm pro good times. I don't care what color you are. You feel me? That's me being pro black. I don't give a damn what color you are. Are you light skin or dark skin? You know what I'm saying? If you're white, if you're yellow, because black comes in all colors. I don't know if y'all knew. You feel me? Black definitely comes in all colors. We speak all languages. We are everywhere. We ain't going nowhere. And I don't care what you feel like. It's just these effects. You feel me? So if I want to be accepted by this world, looking like this, talking like this, acting like this, you know what I'm saying? Not associating with anybody, because at the end of the day, I see through so many things. It's just like, bro, I just want to chill. If I want to sit here and be a spokesperson, in a sense, for people that are like me, veterans, disabled people, people that have been through trauma, people that have been betrayed on a high level, I can't sit here and say that and at the same time say I have an issue with somebody. I can't sit there and say you need to love your enemy when I have enemies. How does that make sense? You get what I mean? In order to love your enemy, you don't have enemies. I ain't got no enemies, you feel me? I ain't got no problems with nobody. And if a person has a problem with me, especially if they're black, even if you look in the mirror and you see a white guy. Yeah, for y'all people out there with those type of mental disorders that you've been so brainwashed that you're like Uncle Ruckus out here, you don't see black. And there are some black people in this world that look in the mirror and don't see black. You know what I'm saying? They either look in the mirror and see blue, they may look in the mirror and see white, they may look in the mirror and see every other color than what they really are. You heard me? Because they've been so taught to hate what looks like them. They are so, and that's, and again, for living in a world full of undiagnosed mental patients, there are so many levels of trauma that have not been documented out here because people are too prideful to go say they need help. That I'm not surprised, bro. I'm not surprised if I were to see somebody that's been, you know what I'm saying, very well kept by another group of people, talk down and tear down their own. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm sitting here, because I know I was in the military. A lot of black people are afraid to go to the military. And I'm like, you know what? We need more black people in the military, because we need more black representation. You know what I mean? The military is one of the best places to get some experience as far as learning how to be a man. A lot of y'all don't know how to wash your clothes on your own. A lot of y'all don't know how to sit there and take care of yourself. The military does that for you, and they do it in a way, and I'm not preaching pro anything. I'm just saying, like, there are avenues for those that are willing to take them, and it may take you to extreme places, but hey, man, the results are the results as long as you're willing to work. You heard me? Like, if you're tired of being in the streets, do something about it. If you're tired of being made fun of, stop being a person that takes that. You know what I'm saying? If you're tired of being tired of not being able to look at yourself for who you are, bro, you have to sit there and understand at the end of the day, even if you are pro-religion or pro-whatever, you have to make the first step in going there, which means it's all up to you. That's your choice. You get me? So if it, for me, it was the military, because I knew I was a rough, tough, ignorantly hard-headed individual that understood the only constant in life is change. And if I'm not willing to take extreme changes for the betterment of me, I might as well be sleeping in my grave. And thank God I did what I did, because I'm here today to tell y'all. You know what I'm saying? And if this is like some kind of messed up joke from the universe, to where I've been through so many extremes to sit here today and be like, I can relate to almost anything. Which is not something that you would want to say if you've been a person that can relate to almost anything. You know what I mean? I have experiences. I've been through things. I've survived things. And I'm here to say, it don't matter what you look like, who you are, your background, things that you can't fix, it don't matter. And if people want to hold things against you that you can't fix, which is the past, you don't need them kind of people around you. And I'm not talking about eliminating them as in hurting them. I mean, you need to do what you need to do for you and get from Rhonda, ASAP, Rocky, you feel me? And it'll be okay. There is no issue with spending time with yourself. A lot of y'all are depressed in groups, self-medicating, self-toxicating, and you're wondering why things just ain't getting better. You have to spend time alone. You feel me? And this is dedicated to anybody and everybody that can understand and hear these words and really take in what I'm saying. If you want to sit there and say Happy Martin Luther King Day to somebody, don't tell me Happy Martin Luther King Day. Be the change that he was talking about. I don't care if you're going up to be a political official. Be the change that he was talking about. Even if it's just, if you go in there with 100% good intentions and they backfire and it's like you're 99% evil, there's 1% of you that still has a lingering of some good. Be the change that he was talking about. If you're going to the military and you know you came in there with 99 or 100% good intentions, but because of so much toxicity in there, it brought your morale down. Yo, you may be 99% evil, but there's 1% of you that's sitting there, you know, that's still good. Be the change that he was talking about. If you're on your job and you're a manager, you know what I mean, on any level, from being a parent to an actual boss or CEO, you feel me? That may, you may have came in there with good intentions. And as time went on, you finally saw what it was like to be in that position, because I've been in managerial positions. You know what I'm saying? I've been in high-level state, national training managerial positions. You know what I'm saying? Like, people, you, like, bruh, when I say I stand up and people have to answer for that, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you know, don't be late when I call you type stuff. You know what I'm saying? You know, you may come in there with good intentions, and over time, being in high leadership positions, it wears you down, because it's like you fought so hard, and then you see what it's really like, and it's like, what's the point? You feel me? There's still a piece of you in there that's, you know, you didn't quit. You got there for a reason. Be the change that you were talking about. If you had a crappy boss, be that uncrappy boss. Even if it takes time, even if you turn into that crappy boss and you're just looking in the mirror, like you can't even recognize yourself, which caveats back to the other point I was making. Even if you can't recognize yourself anymore, understand that there's nothing you can do to fix the past, but what you can do to fix the future, what you can do to fix the present, which is why it's called the present, is just be just a little bit better than you were yesterday. Just a little bit better. Know what I'm saying? And I don't care if it's randomly calling people that you have a real issue with, just to say, you know what, I ain't got no pressure with you. I can't move forward if I'm continuously letting that hold me back. Know what I'm saying? Best of luck. You feel me? I'm gonna go in my direction and I'm gonna be great. You go in your direction, and whatever happens, but how it happens is how it happens. But you have no ill will coming from me to you. And whether you have it or back, or have it back towards me, I'm not accepting it, whether it's good or bad. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to live my life how I want to. You live your life how you want to. And at the end of the day, as long as I'm not bothering nobody, as long as I'm not hurting nobody, let me look, let me walk, let me talk, let me be who I am meant to be, which is only me, the greatest version of me. Let me activate that. You know what I'm saying? And we'll just go from there. You live your life. You do what you do in your house. I'll do what I do in my house. But when we see each other, I will speak. It's respect. You get me? So the best way to not live in a dream, because if I'm dreaming, that means I'm sleeping. You heard me? And right now, we woke. We wide awake right now. And all I need from y'all, all I honestly need from y'all, is to understand, you know what I'm saying? If you're going to sit there and talk from a great man's perspective, then really talk from that great man's perspective. Don't say you're pro anything if you're not going to stand behind it 100%. I'm pro good times. I'm pro the vibe. If I was a demigod, I'm a demigod of relaxation. You feel me? And if I can't sit there and say I need to be accepted for who I am, which is a veteran, a black man, an educator, a healer, a teacher, a speaker, a son of a preacher, a person that's been through so much and survived so much, that the fact that I'm smiling right now alone should let you know that I can do it, you can do it, bruh. I have to accept people for who they are, you know? That means you have to accept people for who they are, which means if you want to be a better person, accept the fact that you suck right now. And the only way to be better is to not suck. You feel me? And that's the best way I could put it. And that's the message for today, man. That's the message for life, bro. Just be cool. You heard me? Everything in your life's gonna work out. Just be cool. Now, I understand it's hard, and I understand you got a lot going on, but you stressing yourself out ain't making it no better. Just be cool. You heard me? Old head who don't know how to talk to these kids. Let these kids be who they are, and they will learn as they go. But when you have a chance to help, help them out. Just be cool. Kids on there who know damn well you ain't supposed to be on there. You know what I'm saying? I understand these old people don't understand what it's like growing up in today's time, because we grew up in different times. But I need you to understand the times that we grew up in were a lot realer than they were today, whether you want to accept that or not. You heard me? And if I'm a little bit hard on you, it's because when I was growing up, I wish somebody would have been that much harder on me, so I wouldn't have to learn everything that I learned the way that I learned it. So all I can say is live your life. I love you. I like you. But be careful and just be cool. You feel me? And that's how we gonna rock today, man. So for all of y'all that was sitting there, you took your time to take your time to come rock with your boy, man. Much love, respect, appreciate it. Make sure you get the merchandise off for HFVibes.org. Make sure you understand that this is a growth channel and we about to go somewhere. Now, I'm talking about this has been the BLOW. You heard me? Watch it blow up. You feel me? And from there, like I said, man, literally made a 31-minute video without cursing one time about being cool, using some big words. You know what I'm saying? Looking just like this. Yeah, man. And that's what it's all about. Daring to be different, but being yourself. You heard me? And like I said, if I was to be anything in this world, you know what I mean? I'm just a chill, cool individual that when you come in my presence, it shall not change. I will always be a chill, cool individual. Just because you're not doesn't mean you can't be, but you can't be my level of it. That's why I said be you. You heard me? And that's all that matter, man. So with that being said, pull out the stick. Pull out the stick. Pull out the positivity. If somebody got a problem with you, it's because they really got a problem with themselves. And then twanky, twanky one, we ain't doing all that. You heard me? Speak peace, live righteously, and it ain't that hard. You feel me? You just make it that way because you got excuses on your mind. So, let's take them excuses away. Like I always say, keep it real. I'd rather use a positivity gun than a real one and tell that person you got a problem with you. Hey, man, I'm sorry your perspective is so small because your ego is so big. Run.